Ladies and gentlemen, we are starting our approach for landing at the airport of Tel Aviv. Fasten your seatbelt again now and refrain from using the washrooms.
We don't have natural resources, we don't have a local fintech industry, we don't have anything locally. We're a tiny country with a tiny local market. We have to use tech.
We believe in the best solutions. We are looking for better solutions for every challenge that we are facing.
If you're taking the number of startups per capita, Israel is a leading country in the world.
Social initiative and not a technological initiative, that our main goal is to close social gaps between center of Israel and the periphery, is to be a growth engine to the Israeli economy and to improve the governmental services to the citizens of Israel.
Unique center which brings together entrepreneurship, innovation and technology to address challenges of humanity, challenges in the fields of digital healthcare, welfare, what we focus on healthy aging, education and smart cities. In this project we're building here a lab, a physical lab in which we're building a house of the elderly adults, and around him we're building all his life cycles aspects. We're building the room of the family, the room of the education, the room of the welfare, room of robotics, and in those rooms we're going to have all the relevant players in Israel which are dealing with the healthy aging population: the social security, the university, the ministry of welfare, the municipality, startups, international companies, and private companies.
The military is an obligatory service here in Israel. We have every kid joining for 2 years if it's a girl and 3 years if it's a boy. And of each one of these classes to join every year, there's a few thousand kids that actually go and have top tech jobs inside the military. Now these are young kids that at a very young age get top tech education, and they get to work on very complex problems that they would never get to work at this age anywhere else in the world. But these organizations inside the military also work like startups, which means it's not like a huge company with very slow work. They work in very small teams, very fast. So when these kids come out, everything, the specific thing they worked on remain in the army, but all their methodology, all their knowledge, all their way of working comes with them.
So we enable everyone to launch a consulting website, define a question, and upload the list of stakeholders that he or she wants to get advice from. After all these people would add advice, the system will generate qualitative insights with the help of the participants, and the decision makers will be able to address these insights, make decisions, and send each and every person a personal update on impact. By that, we make everyone partners of change, and we also enable decision makers to find what works, which is really crucial to deliver change today.
We trust the digitalization because we trust also the cybersecurity capabilities of the country of Israel. Because when you are doing things on the cyber area, you have to make sure that your privacy is kept and the information is very well kept, and your information won't go to the places that you didn't meet.
For a tech ecosystem to really work and for people to be willing to put their lives into tech, you must have the willingness to fail. 19 out of 20 tech projects fail, which means that if you're a startup entrepreneur, you know that you're more likely to fail than to succeed. The only way you can do that is if in the culture around you, failing is acceptable.
If you want to digitize Israel or digitize Germany, you need to speak with cities, you need to speak with local authorities, you need to speak with people who really get these services to understand what works. And the second thing that changed 20 years ago and today is the fact that you cannot lead change by yourself. You need your stakeholders to be behind you.